बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, मैं हूं मोहम्मद मुनीर अहमद। कोर्स है कॉस्ट अकाउंटिंग। आज हम इस कोर्स के यूनिट 1 कॉस्ट कंसेप्ट्स एंड क्लासिफिकेशंस के बारे में डिस्कस करेंगे। इस यूनिट के प्रोग्राम जिसमें डिफरेंट क्लासिफिकेशंस ऑफ कॉस्ट के बारे में बताया गया है, आज हम इन कॉस्ट की क्लासिफिकेशंस के बारे में जानेंगे। आज के प्रोग्राम के जो कंटेंट्स होंगे, इन कंटेंट्स में बेसिक्स ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशंस के, कॉस्ट को किन किन बेसिस पर क्लासिफाई किया जा सकता है, कॉस्ट मे बी क्लासिफाइड इन रिलेशन विद एक्टिविटी, इन रिलेशन टू कॉस्ट ऑब्जेक्ट, चार्जेबिलिटी टू फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स एंड बेसिस ऑफ डिसीजन मेकिंग। सो लेट वी स्टार्ट द फर्स्ट क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कॉस्ट, दैट इज इन रिलेशन विद एक्टिविटी। इन रिलेशन विद एक्टिविटी, कॉस्ट मे बी डिवाइडेड इन टू पार्ट्स, टोटल वेरिएबल कॉस्ट एंड टोटल फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट। टोटल वेरिएबल कॉस्ट वो कॉस्ट है दैट वेरी विद द चेंज इन आउटपुट लेवल। जैसे जैसे एक्टिविटी लेवल चेंज होता है, वेरिएबल कॉस्ट इन टोटल भी वेरी करती है। विद द इंक्रीज इन एक्टिविटी लेवल, टोटल वेरिएबल कॉस्ट इंक्रीजेस, एंड विद द डिक्रीज इन एक्टिविटी लेवल, टोटल वेरिएबल कॉस्ट डिक्रीजेस। द सेकेंड टाइप इज टोटल फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट। दिस कॉस्ट रिमेन्स अनचेंज्ड वन एक्टिविटी चेंजेस। आउटपुट लेवल आपका इंक्रीज हो या डिक्रीज हो, टोटल फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट रिमेन fixed, like your total long distance telephone bill is based on how many minutes you talk. Jitne minutes talk karenge, total long distance telephone bill increase karta jayega. With the decrease in minutes talked, total long distance telephone bill decrease kar jayega. But per unit variable cost remains fixed or constant. The cost per long distance minutes talked is constant. For example, 10 cents per minute. आपकी per unit variable cost fixed रहेगी, जबकि total increase या डिक्रीज करेगी विद द इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज इन एक्टिविटी लेवल। टोटल फिक्स कॉस्ट ऑलवेज रिमेन फिक्स्ड, इररिस्पेक्ट ऑफ दिस कि आपकी आउटपुट लेवल इंक्रीज हो या डिक्रीज हो। योर मंथली बेसिक टेलीफोन बिल प्रोबेबली डज नॉट चेंज व्हेन यू मेक मोर लोकल कॉल्स, whereas fixed cost per unit increases or decreases with the increase or decrease in output level. जैसे जैसे output level increase करता जाएगा, per unit fixed cost decrease करती जाएगी। Here is the summary of total variable and fixed cost. Variable cost in total varies with the change in activity level, whereas per unit variable cost remains constant over wide range of activity. Fixed cost ki agar hum baat karein, it remains fixed in total over the level of activity. within the range of activity level, आपकी activity increase हो या decrease हो, fixed cost remains total. Whereas, per unit fixed cost increases or decreases with the increase or decrease in activity level. Students, if you have understand the concept of fixed cost and variable cost, let me do a quick check. So, if you see which of the following costs would be variable with respect to number of cones sold at a Baskins and Robbins shop. Here four options are given aur inme humne ye dekhna hai ki which cost would be variable. The cost of lighting the store, the wages of the store manager, the cost of ice cream and the cost of napkins for customers. So, here two costs are variable cost. The cost of ice creams, ke jitni ice cream sales ki jayengi, cost of ice cream increase karti jayegi. And the cost of napkins for customers, jitne customers aapke paas aayenge, napkins ki cost bhi increase karti jayegi. Now, another classification of cost is in relation to cost object. And under this classifications, there are two type of costs, direct cost and indirect cost. Direct cost, which can be easily and conveniently traced to the unit of product or other cost object, is known as the direct cost. For example, direct material and direct labor. These are two direct cost jinko hum easily or conveniently traced kar sakte hain kisi bhi unit of product mein or other cost object mein. The second type of cost is indirect cost. That cost which cannot be easily and conveniently traced to a unit of product or other cost object. Ke wo cost jo easily or conveniently traced na ho sake, us cost ko hum indirect cost kehte hain in relation to cost object. For example, manufacturing overheads. Manufacturing overhead wo cost hain jo aasani se kisi bhi cost object mein, किसी भी कॉस्ट यूनिट में ट्रेस्ड और कन्वीनिएंटली आइडेंटिफाई नहीं किए जा सकते. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द थर्ड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कॉस्ट इज इन रिलेशन टू मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कंपनीज. मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कंपनीज में कॉस्ट को हम थ्री पार्ट्स में क्लासिफाई करते हैं. नंबर वन, डायरेक्ट मटेरियल. Number two, direct labor, and number three, manufacturing overheads. Now, we will discuss what are the details of these three elements of cost. First one is the direct materials. Direct material that becomes an integral part of the product and that can be conveniently traced directly to it. Ke wo part material ka jo easily or conveniently kisi bhi product mein traced kiya ja sake aur jo integral part ho us major product ka, that is known as the direct material. For example, radio installed in an automobile. Like tires in automobile, these are examples of direct material. The second component of the cost is direct labor. Those labor costs that can be easily traced to individual units of product is known as the direct labor cost. Okay, jo labor physically or mentally involve ho directly in production process mein, that is known as the direct labor. For example, wages paid to automobile assembly workers, ke jo automobile ke assembling process mein involve honge, wo workers direct labor kehlayegi. And the third component of cost is manufacturing overheads. Manufacturing costs that cannot be traced directly to specific units produced, ke jo specifically units produce kiye gaye hain, un units mein agar cost trace na ki ja sake, that cost is known as the manufacturing overheads. There are two major examples of the manufacturing overheads. These are indirect labor and indirect materials. ये वो दो examples हैं जो major part होते हैं manufacturing overheads का. और in other way हम ये कह सकते हैं किसी भी product को manufacture करने में जितनी भी cost incur की जाती है other than direct material and direct labor is categorized under the head of manufacturing overheads. Manufacturing overheads ko hum factory overheads bhi kehte hain. Indirect labor kya hoti hai? Wages paid to employees who are not directly involved in production work. For example, maintenance workers, janitors and security guards. ये वो workers हैं जो directly production process में involved नहीं होते. That is known as the indirect labor. And indirect materials used to support the production process. कि वो material जो production process को complete करने में support करता है, that is known as the indirect material. That is also not the major part of the product. For example, lubricants and cleaning supplies used in the automobile assembly plant. Here is the summary of manufacturing cost, the direct material, direct labor, and manufacturing overheads. Direct material or direct labor, agar in do costs ko hum add karein, that cost is known as the prime cost. Prime cost ko hum basic cost bhi kehte hain, ki ye wo cost hai that is necessary for the production of any type of product. And the second, if we add direct labor and manufacturing overheads, these two costs are known as the conversion cost. कि ये cost direct material को transform करने में helpful होती है into finished goods. That cost is known as the conversion cost. Another type of cost is non-manufacturing cost that also occurs in manufacturing or trading organizations. Here are two major components of non-manufacturing cost that are marketing or selling cost, and the second one is administrative cost. Costs necessary to get the order and deliver the product is known as the marketing or selling cost, whereas all executive, organizational And clerical costs is known as the administrative cost. Next classification of cost is chargeability to financial statements. Financial statements ko charge karne se related hum cost ko two parts mein divide karte hain. First one is the product cost, the second one is period cost. Product costs include direct materials, direct labor, and manufacturing overheads. These are three major components of a product cost. Product cost, jab hum goods produce kar lete hain, to ise hum as a inventory balance sheet mein record karte hain. Aur jab inventory sold out kar di jati hai, to ye inventory hamara expense ban jati hai, jise hum income statement mein ya profit and loss account statement mein cost of goods sold ke naam se record karte hain. Another type of cost that is recorded in financial statement is period cost. Period costs include all marketing or selling costs and administrative cost. And all these types of costs are recorded as an expenses in income statement. Here is a quick check for the better understanding of the concepts which we discussed. So, which of the following costs would be considered a period rather than a product cost in a manufacturing company? Manufacturing equipment depreciation, property taxes on corporate headquarters, direct material costs, electrical costs to light the production facility, and the last one is the sales commissions. And we have to find that which cost is the period cost. So here two costs are period cost, whereas other three costs are the product cost. In this example, B and E, that are property taxes on corporate headquarters, and sales commissions are the period cost, whereas A, B and D options are belongs to product cost. Dear students, next classification is for decision making. As you know, every decision involves a choice between at least two alternatives, either alternative A, either alternative B. And only those costs and benefits that differ between alternatives are relevant in a decision. All other costs and benefits can and should be ignored. जो कॉस्ट दो डिसीजंस के दरमियान डिफर करे, डैट कॉस्ट इज नोन एज द डिफरेंशियल कॉस्ट. एंड डैट रेवेन्यू डैट डिफर बिटवीन टू अल्टरनेटिव्स, डैट रेवेन्यू इज नोन एज द डिफरेंशियल रेवेन्यूज. कॉस्ट्स एंड रेवेन्यूज that differ among alternatives. For example, you have a job paying rupees 1500 per month in your hometown, and you have a job offer in a neighboring city that pays rupees 2000 per month, and the commuting cost to the city is rupees 300 per month. So, the differential revenue is 500. By deducting 2000 from, by deducting 1500 from 2000. One option 1500 ki given hai and the alternative 2000 ki given hai. Dono source se jo differential revenue hame gain hogi, that is known as the rupees 500. Whereas the differential cost is 300, kyunki in hometown there is no commuting cost. Whereas if you opt the second option, where you will get rupees 2000 per month, you have to pay commuting cost rupees 300. Another cost that belongs to decision making is the opportunity cost. Opportunity cost is that cost, the potential benefit that is given up when one alternative is selected over another. Jab hum ek benefit ko opt karte hain aur ek alternative ko foregone karte hain, then the foregone benefit by choosing one alternative over another is known as the opportunity cost. For example, if you are not attending college, you could be earning rupees 15,000 per year. And your opportunity cost of attending college for 1 year is rupees 15,000. Ki agar aap college attend karte hain, then 15,000 ki aapki earning aapko sacrifice karna padegi. So whatever you are sacrificing by choosing one alternative over another is known as the opportunity cost. The next cost is the sunk cost that also belongs to the decision making. Sunk cost have already been incurred and cannot be changed now or in future. They should be ignored when making decisions. For example, you bought an automobile that cost rupees 10,000 2 years ago. Rupees 10,000 cost is sunk because whether you drive it, park it, or trade it, or sell it, you can't change rupees 10,000 cost that you have incurred. So, sunk cost wo cost hai jo historically aap incur kar chuke hon aur in future ya current decisions us cost ko change na kar sake, that is known as the sunk cost. Here is a quick check. Suppose that your car could be sold now for rupees 5,000. Is this a sunk cost? A option, yes, it is a sunk cost. And the B option, no, it is not a sunk cost. So, let me see what is the correct answer. No, it is not a sunk cost, because the 10,000 cost that has been incurred previously cannot be recovered or cannot be changed. The last classification of cost is on the basis of control, that are controllable costs and uncontrollable cost. A cost is controllable if a manager has the power to determine or at least significantly affect the amount incurred. Ki agar manager level par cost कंट्रोल की जा सकती है. डैट कॉस्ट इज़ नोन एज द कंट्रोलेबल कॉस्ट. और अगर मैनेजर लेवल पर ये कॉस्ट कंट्रोल नहीं की जा सकती, ना ही सिग्निफिकेंटली चेंज की जा सकती है, डैट कॉस्ट इज़ नोन एज द अनकंट्रोलेबल कॉस्ट. डैट कॉस्ट विच आर नॉट विद इन द मैनेजर्स कंट्रोल और इन्फ्लुएंस. क्या मैनेजर ना इन्फ्लुएंस कर सकता है ना उसे कंट्रोल कर सकता है. सो डैट कॉस्ट इज नोन एज द अनकंट्रोलेबल कॉस्ट. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी डिस्कस्ड डिफरेंट क्लासिफिकेशंस टूडे एंड इन दीज क्लासिफिकेशन द फर्स्ट क्लासिफिकेशन वॉज प्रेडिक्टिंग कॉस्ट बिहेवियर, जिसमें हमने फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट और वेरिएबल कॉस्ट को डिस्कस किया. द सेकेंड क्लासिफिकेशन डैट वी डिस्कस्ड असाइनिंग कॉस्ट टू कॉस्ट ऑब्जेक्ट, जिसमें हमने डायरेक्ट और इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट को डिस्कस किया. द थर्ड क्लासिफिकेशन वॉज रिगार्डिंग द फाइनेंशियल रिपोर्टिंग, जिसमें हमने प्रोडक्ट कॉस्ट और पीरियड कॉस्ट को डिस्कस किया. एंड एट द एंड वी डिस्कस्ड द कॉस्ट विच बिलोंग्स टू डिसीजन मेकिंग, डैट आर संक कॉस्ट, अपॉर्चुनिटी कॉस्ट, डिफरेंशियल कॉस्ट एंड डिफरेंशियल रेवेन्यू. होप आज का प्रोग्राम आप बखूबी समझ पाए होंगे. नेक्स्ट प्रोग्राम में नेक्स्ट टॉपिक के साथ मुलाकात होगी. अपना और अपना गिर्दो नवा का ख्याल रखिएगा. अल्लाह हाफिज़.